place the ceramic structure on the tie base. Mark the position of the ceramic structure in relation to the tie base with a waterproof pen. The bonding surface of the tie base must be conditioned before cementation. Apply some silicone or wax to protect the emergence profile and screw channel. Blast the bonding surface of the tie base with aluminium oxide. Observe the instructions of the tie base manufacturer. Remove the silicone or wax and clean the tie base with ultrasound in a water bath or with a steam jet. Apply monobond plus bonding agent to the dry bonding surface of the tie base and allow to react for 60 seconds. Then, evaporate any remaining excess with compressed air that is free of water and oil. Seal the screw channel with a foam pellet or wax. Be careful not to contaminate the bonding surface. The IPS e.max CAD ceramic structure must also be conditioned before cementation. Under no circumstances should the ceramic structure be sandblasted. Apply IPS ceramic etching gel to condition the bonding surface and allow to react for 20 seconds. Then, rinse off with water. Blow dry the restoration. Apply monobond plus to the dried bonding surface and allow to react for 60 seconds. Then, evaporate any remaining excess with air that is free of water and oil. Now, cement the IPS e.max CAD ceramic structure to the tie base using the self-curing multi-link hybrid abutment luting composite. Apply a thin coating of multi-link hybrid abutment directly onto the bonding surface of tie base. Then, apply a thin coating of multi-link hybrid abutment to the bonding surface of the ceramic structure. Next, place the ceramic structure over the tie base in such a way that the position markings are aligned. Verify the correct final position at the transition between the tie base and ceramic structure. Then, press the parts firmly together for 5 seconds. Carefully remove excess multi-link hybrid abutment from the screw channel with a microbrush or brush using rotary movements. Now, carefully remove the foam pellet from the screw channel. Remove circumferential excess cement only after the initial setting phase, which is 2 to 3 minutes after mixing. For the cleanup, use a suitable instrument, such as a Lacron. Apply glycerin gel, such as liquid strip, to the cementation joint to prevent the formation of an inhibition layer before the luting composite autopolymerizes. It takes multi-link hybrid abutment approximately 7 minutes to autopolymerize. Secure the components in the correct position to one another and do not move them. Once autopolymerization is complete, rinse off the glycerine gel with water or steam. If cement residue is left in the screw channel, remove it with suitable rotating instruments. Be careful not to damage the tie base. Carefully polish the cement joint using rubber polishers, for instance, Optrafine, at a low speed of no more than 5,000 revolutions per minute to prevent overheating.